Skeletal system, it is made of bones and cartilages, and that is a, forms a very that makes a very important role in the movement of the body. For example, when we are chewing the food, then the few jaw bones, and when we are walking around, then our limb bones, okay, they all are playing the role in the movement of the body. Bone and cartilage, they are the special type of connective tissues. They are the types of connective tissues, and these bones, as well as the cartilage, they have a very hard matrix, which bones have a hard matrix made of calcium salts, whereas the cartilage is having the chondroitin salts present in it, so that makes it flexible. So in human beings, we have 206 bones and a few cartilages. So it is grouped into two principal divisions. One is axial skeleton. Axial skeleton is made of 80 bones, and the skull, the vertebral column, sternum, and ribs, they all are made of axial skeleton. Skull. When we talk of skull, you can see here in the picture. Skull is made of two sets of bones. One is cranial of this part, and other is facial. Now, and that constitutes a total of 22 bones. So cranial bones, they are 8 in number. Just a second. These cranial bones, they are 8 in number. And they are the hard protective covering cranium of the brain, they are made up of. And the facial region, the facial bones, they are generally 14 skeletal forms, and they form the front part of the skull. A single U-shaped bone called hyoid, you can see here below, hyoid bone. This is the U-shaped bone, which is called as the hyoid, that is present at the base of the buccal cavity. Buccal cavity is the region where the food is chewed. And it is also included in the skull. And the each middle ear, this is the part of the middle ear. Just a second, where's the cursor? Now, here we see that the tiny bones, they are present in the middle ear. So this part is the middle ear, and it consists of malleus, incus, and stapes, which are collectively called as ear ossicles. So the skull region is the superior region, and then the vertebral column, it is attached to the vertebral column. You can see here in this first picture. So this is the vertebral column. So it is attached with the vertebral column with the two occipital condyles. You can see here occipital condyle. From here it is articulated with the vertebral column. So that is why it is called as the dicondylic skull, because it has two occipital condyles with which it is articulated with the vertebral column. Now let's talk about the vertebral column. Now vertebral column consists of 26 serially arranged units, which are called as vertebrae. Okay, this is the part of the backbone, which is called as the vertebrae. And these vertebrae, they are arranged in the special units, which are 26. They are formed of 26 serial bones, and it extends from the base of the skull and constitutes the main framework of the trunk. So each vertebrae has a central hollow portion, which is called as neural canal. So here inside there is a neural canal, and through which the spinal cord passes. First vertebrae is called as the atlas, and it articulates with the occipital condyle of the skull. You can see here occipital condyle of the skull, I have already shown you. So it articulates with here, which is called as the atlas bone. So which is the first vertebrae. So vertebral column is differentiated into a cervical. These are cervical vertebra. So cervical vertebra, they are 7 in number. Then comes the thoracic vertebrae, they are 12 in number, and the sacral. Sacrum, you can see here, which is fused. In the sacral, there is one fused, and in the coccygeal, there is one fused. In this part, we can see. Just a second. And then we see the vertebral column protects the spinal cord, it supports the head, and it serves as a point of attachment of the ribs and the musculature of the back. Then sternum is actually the what is sternum? It is the flat bone in the ventral middle of the thorax. Okay, which more we'll be studying in the rib cage about this. So this is a part of the skeletal system. One is the axial skeleton and the vertebral column. When we see the rib cage, we see that there are 12 pairs of ribs, and each rib is a thin flat bone which is connected dorsally to the vertebral column, and it has two surfaces on the dorsal end, and hence it is called as bicephalic. Why it is called as bicephalic? Because it has two surfaces and it's the dorsal end. You can see here, these are the two surfaces in the dorsal end. That is why it is called as bicephalic. First seven pair of ribs, they are called as the true ribs because they are attached to the thoracic vertebrae and they are connected to the sternum. Sternum, you know, this is the chest bone, breast bone, which is also called as sternum. It is connected to the sternum, and with the it is connected with the help of a cartilage which is called as hyaline cartilage. Then is the 8th, 9th and 10th pair of ribs. They do not directly connect to the sternum, but they join the 7th rib with the help of a hyaline cartilage. Now these are called as the false ribs. These are called as the false ribs or vertebrochondral ribs. They are also called as vertebrochondral ribs. Then the last two pairs, which are the 11th and 12th rib, they are not connected ventrally and therefore they are called as floating ribs. And the sternum, this together forms the rib cage. So the bones of the Here we see that it is divided into three types. One is the true ribs, false ribs and the floating ribs. And this is the diagram of the rib cage. Next we come to appendicular skeleton. Now the bones of the limbs along with their girdles, that is called as appendicular skeleton. You can see here the bones of the limbs, forelimb as well as hind limb. Here each limb is made up of 30 bones, and the bones of the hand, that is forelimb, they are humerus, radius, ulna and carpals. You can see here carpals, metacarpals and phalanges. Carpals, they are the wrist bones, which are 8 in number. Metacarpals, they are palm bones, which are 5 in number. And phalanges, which are also called as digits, they are 14 in number. Now when we see the hind limb, we see the femur. Femur or thigh bone, it is the longest bone in the body. Then comes the tibia and fibula. Now these tibia and fibula, and then later on tarsals, metatarsals and phalanges. Now in the tarsals, we see that they are ankle bones. They are 7 in number. Then comes the metatarsals, which are 5 in number, and phalanges, they are digits, they are called as digits, they are 14 in number. So these are the bones of the legs or of the hind limb. And a cup-shaped bone called patella, you can see here patella, that covers the knees or the ventrally, and this is also called as the kneecap. Then is pectoral and pelvic girdles. You can see here pectoral and pelvic girdles are there. These are the bones that helps in the joining of the upper and the lower limbs with the axial skeleton, and each girdle is formed of two halves, and each half of the pectoral girdle consists of a clavicle. You can see here clavicle, this is the bone in the shoulder. It consists of scapula, a triangular bone in the dorsal part of the thorax between the second and the seventh rib. And the dorsal flat triangular body of the scapula, it has a slightly elevated ridge which is called as the spine. This part is called as the spine. And it is a flat expanded process which is called as acronium. This part is acronium, this part is spine, and this whole is scapula. Now the clavicle articulates with this, and below the acronium is a depression which is called as the glenoid cavity. Here there is a glenoid cavity, and it joins with the head of the humerus. It joins with the head of the humerus and it forms the shoulder joint. And each clavicle is a long slender bone which has two curvatures. It has two curvatures here and here. So this is commonly called as the collarbone. Isko collarbone bhi bola jata hai. Then the pelvic girdle consists of two coxal bones. These are the coxal bones. These are on both the limbs, they are there. So they are two coxal bones, and each coxal bone is formed of the fusion of three bones: ilium, ischium, and pubis. Now at the point of the fusion of these bones is a cavity that is called as acetabulum. Yahan pe cavity hai, usko acetabulum bolte hai. Now in the acetabulum, it is where the thigh bone or the femur joins. Okay, this is the acetabulum. So the two halves of the pelvic girdle, they form a pubic symphysis. So this part and the other part, they combine together and form the pubic symphysis, which contains the fibrous cartilage. Next we talk about joints. They are for all types of movements in the body. Joints are required in the different body parts. Locomotory movements, they are the point of contact between the bones or between the bones and cartilage. So the muscles, they generate a force which is carried out by the movement through these joints. And joints, they are the movability at these joints, it depends on different factors depending on their situation and their functions. So joints, they are classified into three major types. One is fibrous joints, which are immovable. They are immovable, they do not allow any movement, and these type of joints, they are shown in the flat skull, and they are fuse end to end and with a dense fibrous connective tissue in the form of sutures, and then it is called as a cranium. Second type are the cartilaginous joints, which are semi-movable. The bones involved, they join together with the help of the cartilage, and the joints between the adjacent vertebrae in the vertebral column is an example which permits limited movement. Then third type are the synovial joints. Synovial joints, there is a fluid filled cavity that is present between the joints or the surface of the two bones, and this arrangement allows movement, and these joints helps in locomotion and many other movements of the body. Ball and socket joint, which is between the, we have just read in the humer and the pectoral girdle, and the hinge joint, which is between the knees, and the pivot joint, that is between the atlas and the axis, and the gliding joints, which are between the carpals and the saddle joints. Let's see the previous slide for this.